Hi everybody, Paul Richards here. In this vlog, episode 21, we're going to talk about Windows 10 breaking lots of millions of webcams.
Yeah, so there are a lot of unhappy campers out there. We're going to cover some updates that came with the anniversary edition of Windows 10 here.
Stay tuned. So, Windows 10 on the anniversary of Windows 10?
Yeah, so Windows 10, as everybody knows, it was free, you didn't get a choice on updates. Windows 10 Anniversary Edition comes out when you have to start paying for Windows 10 if you didn't do the free upgrade. And lo and behold, a bunch of users with the automatic updates came in to find that their software or their webcam no longer saw each other. So I guess, you know, the MSDM message boards have just been a flutter, and there's tons of information and plenty of misinformation as well that's kind of floating around at the moment. So we decided we'd talk a little bit about what Windows was trying to do, which is actually pretty cool. Talk about what it broke, what it really broke, and then maybe a little surprise at the end. So in the beginning here, what Windows was trying to accomplish, and this is really neat, they're trying to make it so that you plug in any webcam, any video source, doesn't matter what compression algorithms it's using, whether it's H.264, MV12, YUY2, RGB24, the list kind of goes on, that you plug this in and that you will basically have Windows transcode that file for you. So you might think this is no big deal. However, if you are a developer for Windows and you can rely on any video source being one of two formats, it makes your life wonderful. You're not having to sit there figuring all sorts of odds and ends out, or working with different streams from different types of cameras. So in theory, this sounds great. Because going one step further, they're virtualizing your webcam. Your webcam now becomes available to multiple pieces of software. It's no longer you bring it up in Skype for Business, you cannot bring it up in Zoom. It's literally allowing you to bring it up in multiple sources. Unfortunately, the execution was not as good as the idea. So Windows currently cannot properly decode H.264 or motion JPEG. Motion JPEG they're currently working on, and I think the wording was H.264 will be coming at some point. So yeah, this whole idea, yet again, fantastic. Unfortunately for a lot of people, if your camera outputs, say, H.264 to achieve its, you know, proper bandwidth over USB 2, and your software calls for H.264, these two things will no longer work. This poses a real problem for a lot of people who design software or design cameras. In the end, it's really going to be a problem for nobody once they figure it out. But yeah, at the moment, a lot of people are left high and dry. Here at PTZOptics, we're lucky as we actually supply the one native compression color space method that Windows is working fantabulously with, YUY2. This is going to be one of the native formats it works in. So in the future, when you plug in a PTZOptics camera and you have it set to YUY2, it's going to put less of a burden on your PC because you're not having to transcode between H.264 to YUY2 or motion JPEG to YUY2. That being said, we do have H.264 and motion JPEG also available in our cameras. So if you're having problems with your current setup, keep in mind a good PTZOptics might solve your problem.
So I was reading a little bit about this, Matt, and they said that they might fix MJPEG before they fix H.264.
Yes, that's almost a guarantee. Main reason being more of their partners, software developers that they've been working with, work with motion JPEG. If you think of guard stations where they take your picture and badges, a lot of those systems actually utilize motion JPEG. So you can imagine there's a lot of broken systems out there as it currently stands if they migrated to Windows 10.
So that means a lot of Logitech webcams are not working currently. They only do H.264 as far as I know.
Well, so somewhat true. A good example would be the C930E, which was their big kind of splash with H.264. It's a USB 2 camera. It uses H.264 to achieve 1080p 30 over that USB 2 connection. Now, that camera also has YUY2. However, if you put it into, say, 720p even, not even 1920 by 1080, but we're going to do 1280 by 720, you're pulling 8 to 10 frames a second. Mm-hmm. It can't handle all of that data. So while their cameras still will function, it's going to look a little stop motion-y. Not exactly what you want for a fluid conference experience.
Well, Matt, I think that was a really good overview of YUY2, H.264, and MJPEG. Things that a lot of people gloss over, myself included, and now you wonder, you know, how complex and, you know, important they actually are.
Yeah. Well, so, you know, we'll touch on the H.264 over USB just a little bit because it is intriguing. If you have an older PC, a slower PC, you can set our cameras to H.264 and easily plug into a USB 2 port on an older PC, and it is not such a burden to achieve. So it has its place, it has its values, but unfortunately in Windows 10, all those values have just kind of gone away for the moment.
Whew. Well, that's all we have today, folks. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. We have videos coming out every single day.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo. So thanks for watching, everybody. Take care.